been a rough couple days, but I think I'm doing better now that I can finally go back to being myself and go back to the gym. Honestly, I don't know what to do. I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't know what my plan is, but I am a little worried. I'm not going to lie. I keep hearing stories of how bad pulmonary embolisms are. I do think that it was a good thing that they found it, but like I'm worried. Like, how strenuous can I push myself currently? You know, I'm on blood thinners. So my recovery time is not going to go so great. It's basically like I'm not even taking the supplements that I am. And technically, I've stopped taking them because I do it in my leg, and your pulmonary embolisms, from what I saw in ChatGPT, and this may not even be accurate, but I guess anything that goes into your legs can affect your lungs. Don't know how that works exactly, but that's just what it is. And I think that's what the embolism is. It's just the liquid is stuck in between my lungs because maybe I punctured something, an artery or a vein or whatever. And it just circulated into my lungs, and that's where it's at. So, and I think it just needs to be circulated out of there, be pushed out. I don't know if that's what it is. That's just my speculation. I'm not a doctor.
God damn, this heavy.
Maybe all I needed was a warm-up. Let's give this a try. All right, so now I'm going heavier. 140 was pretty easy. How much do you think I should do? 170?
Do the full stack.
I can't do the full stack.
190.
I'll try 190. I'm pretty sure I've done 190 before, but if I pass out, I'm gonna need you to catch me. I don't know if I should be working out, guys. No, I've been dead serious.
All right.
The camera's right there. I don't know if I'm actually going to pass out, but like, I don't know how hard I should be going, which is why I'm trying to take it easy. But if I go too hard, I might pass out. You know? Who knows? Oh, fuck. No, I did not. Didn't go back down. That's pretty good, though. I didn't pass out. Good job on that spot, man.
You could have done more. That was light. Do like fucking
10. All right. I'll do 10 next.
Actually, bro, you might as well do the whole stack if you're going to fucking 10.
Can you do the full stack?
Yeah, probably.
All right. Well, it's 250 the full stack. Well, now you're cheating, man.
No, not with that fucking attachment.
That's the best one. Now I'm gonna do the full stack.
What?
I'm doing 250 now.
Oh, let's see.
You think, how many do you think I can get?
Oh, that's like 10.
I can't get 10. I can't get it down. What did I do last time? 190?
What?
Well, I did 170 last time, right?
Yeah. I think you got maybe 230.
Nah, I'll meet you halfway, 210.
Right. Today we're going to watch Berto tricep push down the 190.
It's just terrible, man. Right.
Wait, restart.
That's going to be a reel right there.
Can I restart?
All right, do it again.
All right, cool. All right, TikTok, today we're going to watch Berto tricep push down 190. Let's go.
You sound like you're moderating a match or something.
Oh, fuck, let's go.
This probably isn't a good thing, but I'm feeling pretty good about myself now, especially after those triceps with whatever his name is. I forget his name. Which is probably a really bad thing because like I went pretty heavy, felt pretty good. I want to go heavier again on the other machines, but I feel like that's going to be a really, really bad thing for me to do. So I'm going to try my best not to do that. Last night's workout was pretty good, man. I'm not going to lie. It was a solid workout. I did a lot more than I thought I could, at least for some of the exercises, but I took it pretty easy. I took it a lot easier than I probably should have, but at the same time, like, I'm still kind of scared of, like, what I can and cannot do. And I'm also, like, the thing that's tripping me up the most is, am I worried about going too heavy, which makes things feel heavier, or do things actually feel heavier because I'm on the blood thinners and I just feel weaker in general, you know? So that's kind of like playing in my head, like, what can I actually do? Not only that, like, I've been backing off from the supplements that I've been taking because I don't want to keep adding more to the problem, if that is the problem. So I'm waiting for my doctor to get the ER stuff, the scans and everything, so they can actually take a look at them and see, all right, yeah, you're clear, you're good to go. Hopefully they're able to take care of that stuff in-house, and I don't have to go to my primary doctor. I have an appointment with my primary doctor, but I rather stick with my private doctor. And by private doctor, I mean, like, primary doctor is your normal general healthcare practitioner that you probably go to ever so often. My private doctor is just like the doctor that gives me my supplements, you know, that I take. And they're not, like, part of, like, the general healthcare stuff, you know. They don't work at a hospital. It's private practice in a general field, you know. They do what they want. They have their own doctors. Cool, perfect. I'm hoping that they're able to just resolve the issues and, like, kind of look after my care in-house than with my general doctor, because that's, I mean, general doctors, that's a whole other thing. This way, my supplement doctor, my TRT doctor, can actually take a look at all my stuff, all my information. They know, like, hey, this could be causing something. I just feel like they have more information because they take care of my thyroid. They see all my labs and everything. They have a good history of, like, 2 years now. Thyroid, all my a full blood panel over the last 2 years, and partial blood panels, which is just a few things. Whereas my primary doctor, they're not running all these tests, you know. They're just doing, all right, this is what's wrong. Let's just do this one test. Let's just do the other test. So the only thing they know is I'm on thyroid medication, and I was just at the ER. And I'm pretty sure I still need to disclose the documents and have some signs. So once I go see my primary doctor, it's good. The first one is going to be useless because I'm pretty sure I'm going to have to sign a form of release allowing them to contact the hospital to access the documents of the ER, where I've already done that step with my private doctor. So hopefully they're able to move on quickly with that. Hopefully next week I get an answer. And, you know, I just hope they're able to do that stuff in-house. At least so far it's been moving quicker, because my primary doctor, it's a few weeks out. You know, it's just, I'd rather just stay with my private doctor. Oh, man, but so far, workout's been great. I'm still trying to take it easy, so I'll be back up to my normal numbers. I don't know why, but my lower back is bothering me, like, today. Last, like, 24, 48 hours. Might be because I've just been at home more often and not being active. And that is just bothering me. I don't think I tweaked it or anything specific. I might just be sleeping wrong, sitting down incorrectly, just slouching. Could be a number of things, but hopefully that goes away pretty soon. That way I can go back to squatting when I can start working out. But I actually, now that I'm thinking about it, I might have to avoid the squatting for a little bit. Maybe a lot more than I would like. Maybe while I'm currently on the blood thinners. Who knows? But with being low on T, I'm definitely not going to be as strong. Won't be building as much muscle. Sucks, but it is what it is. But I'm still going to try to do as much as I can as far as being active. You know, walking on my treadmill, taking it easy, eating my protein as much as I can. And just doing my normal daily habits that I already do. It's just, I won't be getting as much benefit from it in the meantime, because I'm low on my T. sucks, but like I said, this was discovered for a good reason. It sucks how it happened, but it's better that it happened that way than not having it at all and not being discovered, because if life could have been a lot shorter than we than what I would like, to be honest, because yeah, I don't want to be what are the people saying these days? You know what I'm trying to say, but yeah. Thanks for watching. Make sure you click on this video that's showing up on the screen right now to go to the next video. It's either gonna be a previous video, maybe the next video. And don't forget to click on my face, not this face, but the other face in the circle, to subscribe to the channel to continue on to see what's going on with these pulmonary embolism that I'm currently going through.